This is the 3rd of October, and Mrs. Yost is going to receive a special notification today. Classes are getting ready for Mrs. Yost. They said if she knew this was going to happen, she wouldn't show up. And so they're all with their teachers lining up. The excitement is building. Kids are coming from all over. The whole school is turned out here. Look at this. Well, the enthusiasm here is enormous. All these kids.
Come on up, Miss Lacey. Miss Ann is going to be here in 10 minutes. We just talked to her. We're trying to surprise her. And I got to tell you, we need to be quiet because we can hear everything in the office. So she'll know, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to practice the Rock and Robin song. We need everybody to sing. You ready?
Tears. She has always been there, and that's just for me. When
I'm here and I'm crying every day. So we're going to begin today's ceremony by inviting Miss Vanessa Poncher to come up and has a few words to say.
Good morning. Good morning. Welcome. Today is a very special day. From now on at RES, the first Monday in October will officially be proclaimed as Ann Yost Day.
It doesn't even begin to show how much we appreciate everything you've done for us, but it should help you enjoy every minute of your retirement.
Now we're going to do one of Miss Ann's favorite numbers. Get ready.
Thank you.
Exactly. Well, Mr. Torres, what a great tribute to one of your longtime administrative staff people.
Oh, Ann Yost is a treasure, not only to this town, but to this school. I'm starting my fourth year, and when I first got here, I got hired in late February, and I came in not really knowing a whole lot of anything, new to Rosamond, new to the Antelope Valley, new to Rosamond Elementary School. And Ann was an amazing asset. She basically told me all the ins and outs, and I jokingly had mentioned in the speech before we started the presentation that she dried tears, answered frustrations for many, many years. Ann was that sounding board. I would come to her and say, you know, I'm not exactly sure how to handle this. And she was always there. She was here even when she didn't need to be here. And I really meant it when I said that RES wouldn't be RES without Ann. Mm-hmm. She has been impossible to replace. She was the Rockin' Robin for the kids. She would dress up, go out there, interact with the kids, just be our mascot and be amazing. She's organized so many things.
Mm-hmm.
In a word, her professional life can be summed up, she did it for the kids.
Mm-hmm.
And she would love to keep on doing it, but mm-hmm. unfortunately, time catches up with all of us.
Mm-hmm.
But she's an amazing asset to the school, to this community, and I can't even begin to express how appreciative I am of everything that she's done. The success of this school is largely because of her.
Mm-hmm.
She kept mm-hmm. it alive during the lean times, and now she gets to actually just reap the fruits of her labor.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, I asked her, I said, now, Mrs. Yost, what are you going to do? You're a young, vibrant person. Are you going to go climb Mount Everest? She says, well, I might, but then I'm coming back, and I'm going to volunteer to help coach reading. And I thought, what a terrific thing to spend attention on, reading. If those kids can read, they can go anywhere.
Yeah, that's absolutely true, and we'll be very lucky and very blessed to have her come in and continue working with the kids.
Yeah.
She loves these kids, and as you saw today, these kids love her. She's been here for many of them, my fifth graders, since they were in kindergarten.
Mm-hmm.
And she put bandages on their skinned knees. She dried their tears when they were missing mommy. And
yeah,
she's just been amazing. I'm really, really excited that she's going to return and help us out with our reading program. Because you're absolutely right. Without reading, there's nothing else you could do. I mean, you could be the greatest mathematician, but if you can't read the instructions,
mm-hmm.
you're pretty much dead in the water.
She said that the new school going up next door here is going to help everyone, but she said that the real heart of Rosamond Elementary were the little foots, the little people, the parents, and kept saying how great the teachers were, how great the administrators were, and I thought that was very touching of her to say that.
Well, she's absolutely right. I mean, we have buildings. You can put up buildings. You can put in sidewalks. But the actual heart and soul is
sure.
the kids. And she's a big factor in that. She's molded a lot of these lives. She's taken a lot of kids that have come in here from not ideal situations at home and made this their home,
mm-hmm.
giving them a safe place for them to succeed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, Mr. Torres, thank you so much for putting this on today and for giving such a great tribute to Mrs. Yost.
Well, it was my pleasure, but in all honesty, it was the Sunshine Committee and my vice principal that put this all together, because unfortunately, last week I was in training.
Thank you. Okay, Mr. President, I'm going to move over here. We're going to get the kids right here. Nice job, Ms. Jackson.
Thank you.
Yes.
Next, we're going out to fifth grade, and they're going to throw marshmallows at her, which is a RES tradition. Then we're going over to the special ed class, and they're going to do the song in sign language for her.
Super. I'll follow along. I'll follow along.
Good, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good job, fifth grade.
Love you. Thank you so much. Love you. That was the best. Best. Snowball fight in October.
No more. They're like, can we still go?
Souvenir. This marshmallow.
Yes. I had to come first.
And
yes,
she was
like, oh, cool. You get to be a part of history. You get to celebrate the first day.
And Annie, this was supposed to happen yesterday, but you
grabbed it. Yeah.
Yeah. Over there. We got our marshmallows yesterday.
I grew up here. I graduated from Rosamond High School, went to the middle school.
Yes. And how did you end up at Rosamond Elementary School?
Well, I first started out at the high school and then moved over here under a principal by the name of Vic Cantelmo.
Yes, Vic Cantelmo.
And he hired me for the position and just stayed.
Hired you to do?
A paraeducator.
Paraeducator in the classroom.
Uh-huh. And then okay. I moved to the attendance clerk.
Uh-huh.
And then a little bit in the records clerk. And then Mr. Feikert.
Yes.
Hired me as his secretary.
Okay. And that's where you've been for?
That's where I've been. I've been the secretary for 20 years.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Well, the tribute that we saw this morning, 800 hugs, I guess.
800 hugs.
How does a person generate that?
I don't know that one ever can. It's an amazing feeling to be around. What a blessing to be able to work with little children and influence their lives. And
such enthusiasm. Uh-huh.
That's our future.
Yes.
That's who's there.
Uh-huh.
It is important.
Right, and they...
It's important for families to know when they send their children to school.
Uh-huh.
That people here love them. And you couldn't ask for a better group of people to love their children.
Uh-huh.
They truly do. They're the most committed staff. They're the most loving, genuine people you could ever meet.
Yes.
And those children respond because they know they're loved.
Uh-huh.
They know they're safe.
Yes. Yes.
In today's world, children can learn if they're loved and safe.
Uh-huh. Sure, sure. Well, all the words are kind of not adequate enough to describe what actually happened this morning. The whole school turned out with things they had made for you. And
some flowers and... I'll be busy reading all winter.
I know. But they wanted to do it. They were excited to do it, and they stood there for 15 minutes.
Bless their little hearts.
Uh-huh.
When they could be eating their snacks.
Yeah.
And playing on the playground. It was a blessing.
No, it was an important thing for them, and how they responded was just tremendous. And you took the time to hug each one.
I was blessed to get to hug each one.
Uh-huh.
A blessing.
Yeah, true.
A blessing. It's been
true enough. And now, what are your plans? You're still a young person, vibrant person. You're going to climb Mount Everest or something like that.
I think so. I hope to spend a lot of time here. I want to be a volunteer.
Uh huh.
Listen to them read and take a different part in their lives now.
Uh huh.
I'm not ready to let them go.
No.
No.
Okay.
So we'll travel and then spend a lot of time here.
Uh-huh.
I'm blessed to be able to have teachers that have said, come listen to our students read. And
oh, so important.
Can't wait for that. It is.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, so important.
Yeah.
And your family now, you said you were born here.
I was not born,
here.
But came here in 1964.
64, okay. The family moved here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And now I was... saw some people with name badges that said Yost on it,
mm-hmm.
and they were telling me how many Yosts are in the school today.
Yep, my three children went through here, and my grandchildren have gone through here, and we enrolled children of grandparents here. So it's generational little school, and it's a marvelous little school, and it has incredible, if these walls could talk.
Oh, I'm sure.
The story they would tell.
Sure, sure.
Of teachers who have gone here and come back to teach.
So uh-huh.
Pretty wonderful.
Sure, and a great board of trustees, and luckily a succession of teachers and superintendents that really have had great capacity to expand and go find help other places.
It's a wonderful school district. Uh-huh. It's a wonderful place to work.
Wonderful.
It's a wonderful community.
Uh-huh. Well, best of luck.
Thank you.
And thanks for sharing it with the public, because once they see that something like that can happen, it, I think, gives people encouragement.
Well, it's a wonderful blessing that we've had. It's a wonderful community, and as you can see, the most incredible little hearts
yes.
are right here.
Uh-huh. Thank you.